Ashwini, junior resident from SMS Medical College, Jaipur, Rajasthan. Thank you, MRI Teaching Course, for this opportunity to present my research article on the delayed cardiac shimmering, the role of late gadolinium enhancement pattern in cardiac MRI. The notion of late myocardial enhancement in contrast enhanced cardiac MR is currently being used to evaluate the myocardial viability. The area of accumulation of the gadolinium-based contrast agents in the tissues reflects irrevocable damage after coronic myocardial infarction. Many studies have proven this technique to be feasible juxtaposed with other methods and with regard to the outcome after revascularization in the cardiac coronary artery disease. Whereas late gadolinium enhancement is very sensitive in characterizing myocardial scarring, though not specific to the ischemic damage, since gadopentate digoglycan generally accumulates in the tissue with increased water content. Thus, late gadolinium enhancement usually occurs in myocardial areas of fibrosis, edema, and inflammation, where the volume of extracellular component has increased. Different myocardial disorders can be distinguished from ischemic based on the pattern and the localization of the LG in the contrast-enhanced MRI. Purpose of the study is to evaluate the role of late gadolinium enhancement pattern in differentiating ischemic from the non-ischemic cardiac disease, to study the role of late gadolinium enhancement imaging in differentiating viable from the non-viable myocardium in ischemic heart disease, and identifying potential complications of myocardial infarction. Our study included 39 patients who were referred from the cardiology department to the Department of Preventive Diagnosis for ECG-gated multiparametric contrast-enhanced MRI, cardiac MRI workup using the Philips Ingenia 3 Tesla MRI scanner with dedicated protocol involving the turbospin echo, gradient echo, dynamic CT imaging using steady state free precision sequence, short-term inversion recovery sequences for edema imaging, delayed gadolinium enhancement sequences using phase-sensitive inversion recovery sequences 10 minutes after the contrast injection. Patients who had late gadolinium enhancement were included in our study. All data sets were with LG after the contrast were reviewed and extend, that is subendocardial, mid-myocardial, sub-epicardial, transmural, and pattern, that is area, intensity, and distribution were evaluated. Left ventricular LG was described according to the American Heart Association 17-segment model. In all patients with history of myocardial infarction or angiographically proven coronary artery disease with coronary distribution of LG, ischemic pattern was suspected, which were reviewed in the post-contrast images. However, those in which angiographically excluded CAD or no history of MI, LG of the non-ischemic pattern was suspected. Final diagnosis was reached on the basis of clinical features, appropriate blood investigations, ECG, echocardiography, and cardiac MR. Our study included 39 patients of the age group 30 to 66 years, in which 27 were male and 12 were females. Most common presenting symptom was the chest pain, followed by breathlessness and palpitation. The most common comorbidity was hypertension, followed by diabetes and hypothyroidism. Those with ischemic pattern scar were 24, and which is 62% of the total cases, and 38% of the total cases included non-ischemic pattern in the pie chart. The bar graph shows the vascular territory involvement. The most common vascular territory involved was LAD. Transmural scar was seen in 8 out of 24 patients of the ischemic group. Scar score allotted to the left ventricle, according to the 17-segment model, ranged from 18 to 43 and was found to be more in cases of comorbidities like hypertension and diabetes. Transmurality index ranged from 3 to 9, which is a predictor of reversibility after revascularization. Greater than transmurality index, poorer the prognosis for recovery of myocardial contractility after treatment. Microvascular obstruction or no reflow phenomenon was seen in 6 out of 24 patients of the ischemic group, which indicates severe ischemic disease and is associated with poor prognosis, adverse cardiovascular events, and adverse ventricular remodeling. Coming to the first case, this is a 33-year-old male with a history of coronary artery disease. Image A is the vertical long axis cine image of the balanced turbo field echo, showing extensive thinning of the anterior wall of the ventricle, extending from the mid to apex of the left ventricle. The B and C images are post-contrast late gadolinium enhancement images, showing subendocardial to mid-myocardial scar from the mid to distal left ventricle. And the C image shows a low signal linear area in the left ventricular wall, suggesting microvascular obstruction. Second case is a 59-year-old male who was angiographically diagnosed coronary artery disease, was referred for viability study. Image is the vertical short axis image, which is a star image showing the myocardial edema. B and C images are the post-contrast gadolinium enhanced images, which is showing subendocardial to mid-myocardial scar which is extending up to the apex, and there's a low signal area in the left ventricular wall suggesting microvascular obstruction. Among the 15 non-ischemic group, following other cases which is showing the late gadolinium enhancement, we had 3 cases of myocarditis, 4 cases of pericarditis, 2 cases of sarcoidosis, 1 case each of amyloidosis, dilated cardiomyopathy, scarred myocardium due to congenital heart disease, and 3 cases of hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. These are different patterns of which are specific for the non-ischemic late gadolinium enhancement patterns in our cases. This is the first case in the non-ischemic group, which is a 65-year-old male with the symptoms of cardiac failure, shows the diastolic frames of cine images of the vertical long axis, horizontal long axis, and the short axis images showing thickened LV with suboptimal nulling of the left and like the myocardium with mild pericardial effusion and the bilateral pleural effusion. This is the late gadolinium enhancement images showing this global subendocardial patchy mid-myocardium in a non-coronary artery distribution suggesting non-ischemic LG, which has turned out to be cardiac amyloidosis after the fat pad biopsy, which revealed the cardiac which revealed the amyloidosis. This is a strain echocardiography which was done after the MR diagnosis showed there is sparing of the apex with involvement of the base. For 66-year-old female with history of acute diffusive constrictive pericarditis, cardiac failure on colchicine treatment and cardiac MRI for recurrence of the chest pain since 1 month. Image A is a star image which is showing no high signal intensity, suggesting absence of myocardial edema, suggesting it is a chronic event. And B and C images, the post-gadolinium enhancement images showing there is circumferential pericardial enhancement more marked along the right ventricular free wall, suggesting chronic pericarditis. The 55-year-old female with suspected restrictive cardiomyopathy underwent cardiac MRI. A and B images are the showing the severe left ventricular atrial enlargement with small-sized LV cavity with thickened basal to mid-interventricular septum and anterior LV free wall with systolic obliteration of the left ventricular cavity and apical ballooning with thinned out left ventricular wall and left ventricular apex. C image is the post-contrast image showing there is a thickened portion of the myocardium showing the scar. So 46-year-old male who is a known case of severe valvular PS with recurrent apical ventricular tachycardia was underwent cardiac MRI to look for the focus of arrhythmia. There was a dilated and trabeculated left ventricular wall with late gadolinium enhancement seen in the right ventricular free wall. Conclusion: late gadolinium enhancement is a contrast enhanced cardiac MRI is not specific for the ischemic infarction. LG in ischemia almost always involves subendocardial layer where it does not necessarily seen in the other myocardial diseases. Therefore, if the LG excludes subendocardial layer, non-ischemic myocardial diseases must be considered as treatment protocol differs in these both patterns. The specific pattern of late gadolinium enhancement is used utilitarian to identify different myopericardial diseases and thereby helping the clinicians to appropriate management. These are my references. Thank you.